Hello and welcome to the lecture of coordination chemistry. In the previous lecture, we are classifying ligand on the basis of denticity. In the previous class, we have seen that we have done the classification of ligand on the basis of denticity. Now, in this class, we'll mainly talk about bridging ligand, then chelating ligand or chelating ligand, and then we'll also touch one concept of metal ligand bonding, metal ligand bonding, that is HSAB concept, hard soft acid base concept. So in this lecture, we'll mainly deal with these three things: bridging ligand, chelating ligand, metal ligand bonding, that is HSAB concept. So first, to begin with bridging ligand, at first we'll talk about bridging ligand. So what is bridging ligand? So a ligand which has more than one lone pair, which can coordinate simultaneously with two different metal atoms. That means a ligand having more than one lone pair of electron which can coordinate simultaneously, that means at a time, simultaneously at a time, which can coordinate simultaneously with two different metal atom. Now when I will give you example, it will be clear to you. Now you know that hydrogen NH2 N2H4, this ligand has two lone pair of electrons, one lone pair in this nitrogen and another lone pair in this nitrogen. That means this is a ligand which has more than one lone pair of electron, and bridging ligand is that ligand which has more than one lone pair of electron and which can coordinate simultaneously, that means at a time, with two different metal atom. Now this nitrogen can coordinate with metal one, and this side nitrogen lone pair can coordinate with another metal. That means this NH2 and NH2, I can call it as bridging ligand. Fine, so this is the example of bridging ligand. That means this is a ligand NH2, it has more than one lone pair of electron, yes, and in the same complex, one end is attached with a metal center and the another end is attached with another metal center. That means a ligand having more than one lone pair of electron can coordinate simultaneously, that means at a time, with two different metal atom. That kind of ligand is called bridging ligand. So this is an example. Another example, you can see CO3 2 minus. So if you see the example of CO3 2 minus, then C double bond O minus, and this O minus can coordinate with metal 1 and this O minus can coordinate with metal 2. That means this is a ligand which has more than one lone pair of electron and which can coordinate with two different metal center at a time simultaneously. That means it is also an example of bridging ligand. Fine. It is also an example of bridging ligand. That means monodentate ligand such as F minus, Cl minus, if you say these are bridging ligand, yes. Flexi-oriented ligand like carbonate, nitrate, these are also bridging ligand, this can also act as a bridging ligand. So monodentate ligand, carbonate, nitrate, which shows flexi-oriented character, that also can act as a bridging ligand. That means monodentate ligand, flexi-oriented ligand, as well as bidentate ligand, polydentate ligand, these all can act as a bridging ligand. Now you know the concept of bridging ligand, what all can be used as bridging ligand. And also you have seen that NH2 which does not act as, we have seen earlier that this NH2 does not act as a bidentate ligand like this, because the three member chelate ring formed by this is not stable. That is why NH2 acts as a monodentate ligand. But NH2 can act as a bridging ligand. That means the lone pairs present in the N atom can simultaneously at a time can coordinate with two different metal center. That means NH2, it is a monodentate ligand. It cannot act as a bidentate ligand, but NH2 can act as a bridging ligand. So the concept of bridging ligand is clear to you. Fine. Next, we'll move into the chelating ligand or chelating ligand. Now let's talk about chelating ligand. So now, chelating ligand. So what is chelating ligand? A ligand which has two or more than two donor atoms. A ligand which has two or more than two donor atoms which can coordinate with the same metal center. That ligand is called chelating ligand. Fine. So a ligand having two or more donor atom which can coordinate with the same metal center is called chelating ligand. Fine. Is called chelating ligand. That means the complex formed, the coordination complex formed by the chelating ligand is called the chelate. That means chelate is the complex formed by chelating ligand. Fine. That means what is chelating ligand? The ligand which has two or more than two donor atoms which can coordinate with the same metal center is called chelating ligand. And the complex formed by the chelating ligand, what we call as chelate. Fine. And chelating ligand forms chelate. And chelate means there is a ring formation. So the ring formation of the ring formation tendency, the ring formation of chelating ligand is what we call chelation. So the what is chelation, if you are asked? And chelation is the ring formation phenomena. That means ring formation due to the coordination of the two or more donor sites of the ligand with the same central metal atom is what we call chelation. That means chelating ligand is that ligand which has two or more than two donor atoms which can coordinate with the same metal center is called chelating ligand. The complex formed by the chelating ligand, what we call as chelate. Chelate means there is a ring formation. So this ring formation phenomena, what we call as chelation. Fine. Now, what is chelate effect or chelating effect? Chilaert effect can be defined as the unusual stability of the complex formed by the chelating ligand. So Chilaert effect can be described as the unusual stability of the chelate formed by the chelating ligand. Fine. So may be defined as the unusual stability of the chelate formed by chelating ligand is what we call as Chilaert effect. Fine. Now if you see example, then you have CH2 NH2 NH2. So there is two donor sites, and these two donor sites can coordinate with the same metal center. That means this is a ring formation occurs. That means you can say this is a chelate. That means the ligand is a chelating ligand. Fine. Now if I give you example, then it will be more clear to you. We will take the example of Ni2+ + 6NH3, and this will be Ni NH3 whole 6 2+, and if you take Ni2+ + 3En, now En means CH2 like this. So Ni En whole 3 2 plus. Now if you see the stability constant value of this, then you will see that this is 10^8, and if you see the stability constant of this complex, then it is almost 10^18. That means this complex is almost 10^10 times more stable than Ni NH3 whole 6 2+. Fine. Now if you see the structure of Ni NH3 whole 6 2+, then Ni2+ NH3 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 NH3, so NH3 like this. And if you see the structure of this complex, then you can see that like this. Now CH2 CH2, so like this. So if you see the structure, then this is like this. That means you can see here also, this the nickel is in nickel 2 plus state in both the complex. Here also 6 NiN bond, and here also you see Ni is in plus 2 state, and there is 6 NiN bond. That means what is the difference? What is the reason still then this complex is 10^10 times more stable? We are observing that in this complex Ni is in plus 2 state. In this complex also Ni is in plus 2 state. Here also there is 6 NiN bond. In this complex also there is 6 NiN bond. But still if you see the stability constant, this is 10^8 and this is 10^18 almost. That means this complex is 10^10 times more stable. Now the reason is, thus En is a chelating ligand. That means chelate effect is the reason for the unusual stability of the of this complex. Fine. That means what we are saying, chelate effect is the reason behind the stability of the Ni En 3 2+ complex. So Chilaert effect is the reason behind the more stability. Now, then what is chelate effect? That means we can say chelate effect is the reason behind the more stability of NiN3 2 plus complex than NiNH3 whole 6 2 plus complex. Fine. That means, you know, En is a bidentate chelating ligand, you can say bidentate chelating ligand which forms ring. Fine. But NH3 is a monodentate ligand. Fine. NH3 is a monodentate ligand. That means, what is chelate effect? Chelate effect can be defined as the unusual stability of the coordination complex formed by multidentate chelating ligand as compared to equivalent number of monodentate ligand. Fine. So this is chelate effect. And that means, what is chelate effect? Chelate effect can be defined as the unusual stability of the coordination complex formed by multidentate chelating ligand as compared to equivalent number of monodentate ligand. That means, in the previous example, now you can understand that NiNH3 whole 6 2 plus 6 NiN bonds, NH3 is monodentate ligand. Here En is bidentate chelating ligand, that means ring is formed, and you see here also 6 NiN bonds forms, but still this complex NiN whole 6 2 plus is unusually more stable than NiNH3 whole 6 2 plus, 10 to the 10 times more stable. So the reason is chelate effect. Fine. So what is chelate effect? Now you know, as En is a bidentate chelating ligand, NH3 is a monodentate ligand, and chelate effect can be defined as the unusual stability of the coordination complex formed by multidentate chelating ligand as compared to equivalent number of monodentate ligand. Fine. This is chelate effect. That means, what we are saying, the chelating complex, the chelate complex formed by the polydentate ligand is thermodynamically more stable than the complex of the same metal with equivalent number of monodentate ligand. That means, what we are saying, the chelate complex formed by polydentate ligand is thermodynamically more stable than the complex of the same metal with equivalent number of monodentate ligand. This we are saying, and we have seen this with an example, that by the reaction of Ni2 plus 6 NH3, NiNH3 whole 6 2 plus, this complex is formed. If you see the stability constant, this is 10 to the power 8, but the chelating complex, the chelate, as En is a bidentate chelating ligand, so NiN whole 3 2 plus, the stability constant is very high, 10 to the power 18. That means, this complex is 10 to the power 10 times more stable than Ni(NH3)2+. So this is due to the chelate effect, and we are saying that this is a statement: the chelate complex found by polydentate ligand is thermodynamically more stable than the complex of the same metal with equivalent number of monodentate ligand. But this we understand that this is the statement. But what is the reason of showing this unusual stability due to chelate effect? So what is the reason? What is the reason of, you can say, chelate effect? Now let's understand what is the reason. So this is the question now. What is the reason of showing unusual stability? That means, what is the reason of chelate effect? Fine. So let's understand what is the reason. If you see the reason behind chelate effect, then take the example Mn plus is a general scheme XL, and AmLx, this compound is formed. This is N plus. So if you see the equilibrium constant, or the stability constant, or you can say the formation constant, as K equilibrium, you can say AmLx means product by reactant Mn plus L to the power X. Fine. Okay. Now you know this thing, delta H equal to delta G equal to delta H minus T delta S. Fine. And you also know in terms of equilibrium constant, delta H equal to minus RT ln EQ. These two things you know. So that means we know this delta G in terms of equilibrium constant, you can write stability constant ln K equilibrium. Fine. So ln K equilibrium is minus delta G by RT. Fine. Or you can write K equilibrium is equal to e to the power minus delta G by RT. Fine. Now you also know this delta G equal to delta H minus T delta S. So you put instead of delta G, delta H minus T delta S. Fine. K equilibrium is equal to minus delta H minus T delta S by RT. Fine. So K equilibrium equal to e to the power minus delta H by RT and e to the power plus delta S by R. Fine. So TT will cancel out, and this is minus, this is minus, so this will be plus. So e to the power delta S by R and e to the power minus delta H by RT. Now write this again. That means what we are getting, K equilibrium is equal to minus delta H by RT is delta S by R. Fine. This we are getting. That means this is negative before delta H. That means what we can say, if delta H increases, enthalpy change increases, enthalpy increases, then K equilibrium, that means stability constant, will decrease. And if delta S increases, K equilibrium will increase. This we can say from this equation. Fine. That means what we can say, that there are two factors. One is enthalpy and another one is entropy. If delta H increases, stability constant decreases. If entropy increases, equilibrium constant also increases. Fine. These two things we know. Now we have to see the example again. You see the example Ni(NH3)2+ and Ni(En)3)2+, then you can see that in both the cases there are 6 NiN bonds formed. That means 6 NiN bond is forming. That means you can say for both the reaction, so reaction was from Ni2 plus plus 6 NH3, and it was Ni2 plus plus 3N, right? 3N. So in both the cases, 6 NiN bond is forming. That means you can say more or less delta H is same for both the reaction. Delta H is same. That means the only thing that remains is delta S. That means you can say the unusual stability of NiN3 En2 plus compared to NiNH3 6 2 plus, this cannot be explained by delta H, because delta is more or less same for both the reactions, because in both the reactions 6 NiN bond is forming. So delta H cannot be the deciding factor. That means deciding factor is delta S, that means entropy. So what we can conclude from here is that the Chilet effect is mainly due to entropy. So entropy is the main controlling factor of Chilet effect and not enthalpy, because you see enthalpy is more or less same because the same number of bonds are forming, but that means it leaves only entropy. That means you can understand that entropy is the main controlling factor, main deciding factor of Chilet effect. So if you are asked a question that Chilet effect is due to mainly it is due to entropy. So mainly due to entropy, fine, Chilet effect. Now let's understand this entropy phenomena with example. So let's see the phenomenon of entropy effect with an example. So let's understand how entropy is responsible for the Chilet effect. So if you take example, Ni is 2 whole 6 2 plus plus 6 NH3 to Ni NH3 whole 6 2 plus plus 6 H2, fine. And another example is Ni H2 whole 6 2 plus plus 3 N Ni N whole 3 2 plus plus 6 H2O, fine. As I have earlier said, here also 6 NiN bond, here also 6 NiN bond. That means delta H is not a factor, and fine. So delta S is the factor. Now if you see in the first reaction, for the first reaction if you count the delta N, that means product minus reactant, so there is one molecule, there is 6, that means 7, and in the reactant 1 and 6, that means 7, so 7 minus 7, so delta N is 0. If you see for the second reaction, delta N product minus reactant, so 1 and 6, that is 7 minus 3 and 1, it means 4, it means delta N is 3. So for this delta N is equal to 0, and for this the delta N 3. That means if you go from this reaction to this reaction, the delta N is increasing. So for the second reaction, delta N is more, and you know delta N is more means randomness is more, that means entropy is more. So for the second reaction, as the delta N is increasing, delta N is more, that means entropy will be more, delta S will be more, fine. Now, as I have earlier said, that from this equation K equilibrium, this we have already seen, that minus delta H by RT and e to the power delta S by R. From this equation we can say, so this is the stability constant. So if delta S increases, that means stability constant will also increase. That means that for equation 1 and equation 2, the stability constant will be more for which one? The stability constant will be more for the second reaction. The reason is this. That means for the first reaction, delta N is 0. For the second reaction, delta N is 3. That means for the second reaction, delta N is more. As the delta N is more, that means randomness is more. That means delta S entropy is more. Now from this equation, you can understand that as delta S is increasing, as entropy is increasing, the stability constant will also increase. That means chelate effect is due to the entropy effect. So chelation is mainly due to entropy effect. Now you can ask that in this complex there is, so in chelate there is ring formation. So there is ring formation occurs in chelation, and as you know, in ring formation generally what happens? Entropy decreases. Yes, that is a factor, but the ring formation is occurring in chelate complex, and due to that cyclization the entropy is decreasing, but that factor is very minimal here. That means we can ignore that part. Yes, that part is there, cyclization ring formation is there, and due to that entropy is decreasing, but that factor is so minimum, so less important, that we can ignore that part. That part is not important to us. Yes, the entropy is decreasing, but delta N is so high and delta S is increasing in this case is so high that this decrease in entropy is not that much significant as compared to the increase in entropy. Fine. That means this part we can ignore, that cyclization part, and due to that the entropy is decreasing. That part is so less important to us that we can ignore that part, and delta N is increasing, so delta S will increase. That means chelate effect is mainly due to entropy effect. So far we are talking about the classification of ligand. So far we have read the classification of ligand on the basis of nature, organic, inorganic, on the basis of nature, hard and soft, on the basis of charge, anionic, cationic and neutral, on the basis of bonding pattern, sigma donor plus weak pi donor, sigma donor plus strong pi donor, sigma donor plus pi acceptor, pi donor plus pi acceptor. Then we have talked about classification of ligand on the basis of denticity. We have seen monodentate ligand, polydentate ligand. We have seen ambidentate ligand, flexidentate ligand. And today we have read bridging ligand, then chelating ligand, chelation, entropy effect, all these things. Next, we'll move into the topic of new topic, metal ligand bonding. So classification of ligand is finished. So now metal ligand bonding. Fine. Under metal ligand bonding, at first we'll read HSAB concept. So I will just touch the concept to the main theme of the concept I will tell, and then elaborate discussion will be on the next class. So in the coordination compound, in the very first lecture, we already know from the discussion of coordination compound that in coordination compound, metal is generally electron acceptor and ligand is generally the electron donor. So if you see in the Lewis sense, then metal is Lewis acid and ligand is Lewis base. You know this. And the adax coordination compound, that coordination compound, that is why we say is a Lewis acid, Lewis base or acid base adduct. Fine, in the Lewis sense. So what is HSAB concept is that it is an empirical rule, you can say. That means based on observation, it is based on observation. So what it is saying, HSAB concept, that means hard, soft, acid base concept. Right? Hard, soft, acid base concept. What it is saying, that hard metal plus hard ligand, and soft metal plus soft ligand will produce stable coordination complexes, will produce stable species, stable coordination complexes. Now this HSAB concept is an empirical formula, empirical rule you can say. That means empirical rule, that means it is based on observation. And it is based on observation. So what it is saying? It is saying that hard metal and hard ligand or soft metal and soft ligand combination will produce stable species. This is the main theme of HSAB concept. This HSAB concept, hard, soft, acid, base concept, we will deal in details in the next class. So in today's class, what we have read? We have read about bridging ligand at first, then we have seen the examples, then we have read about the chelating ligand, chelation, chelate effect. Chelate effect is due to entropy, mainly due to the entropy. And then at last, metal ligand bonding. The one of the concept is hard, soft, acid base concept, means hard metal, hard ligand combination or soft metal, soft ligand combination will produce stable species, which is an empirical rule. That means it is based on observation. So that's it for today's lecture.